very useful mathematical tool. For study and control of systems in Laplace domain. The reasons for transforming the domain from time domain to Laplace domain is that we have many advantages in analysis and design of our control systems. Obviously, we will understand this not immediately, but we will see this during this course. So, first of all, what is Laplace transform? Okay, so let's see mathematically what this means. So first of all, we refer to functions of time, which are defined from an interval I, which contains at least the interval 0 infinity. So functions defined for at least t greater or equal than 0. And these functions may have complex values. So the image is C. So it is possible to associate to these functions of time a function of complex variable S. So to F, we can associate in the way we will see in a moment a transformation of the function which will be called the Laplace transform of F. Laplace transform is a function of S. So this denotes basically, we use this notation to denote the transform of function F. And then you see, we change the domain of the function from time to S. Which is a variable in the complex plane. So how is defined L of F? Okay. So it's the integral in between 0 and infinity of the real exponential, of the complex exponential e to minus st f of t in the t. Okay. obviously under the hypothesis that this integral, this is an improper integral. So whenever this exists for a certain value of s. Okay, so this is whenever the integral on the right exists for at least one value of s, this is called the Laplace transform of f at s. Okay, so this is the definition of Laplace transform at S. So some important remarks. First of all, you see that the part of the domain of the function t which is really important for the transform is from 0 to infinity. Okay, so this is an important point. This means that two functions f one and f two which coincide for t greater or equal than zero and are different for t less than zero have the same transform at the same s. Okay. So in this in some sense, you have an equivalence class in the sense that you may think that two functions are in the same equivalence class if they coincide on the domain zero infinity, in the sense that they have the same Laplace transform. So it's not important. So the first important point here is that it's not important how the function is before t equal to zero. Okay. Another point is important point is the following. So say that you have at least one such S zero for which the transform is defined at S zero. So For example, okay, so you have the Laplace transform at least one point S0. Okay. In particular, conditions for existence of this integral are stated in this way, so on the module. Okay. So basically, if this integral is finite, obviously also the above one, so the Laplace transform actually exists. So this is, I don't know, maybe you remember, it's the absolute integrability condition for an integral. Okay. So this means the module of this complex number. Remember that f of t is a real function, but this is a complex exponential. Okay. So what you have inside the integral is a complex function. Okay, so if the module of this function, the module of this complex quantity is integrable, then clearly also the integral of the same number is makes sense, is finite. Okay, exists. Okay, if you have this S0, so this is your complex plane, and you have this S0 somewhere in the plane here. Okay, notice basically that the module of this, which is the argument of the integral, is equal to this, and okay, let's recall what a complex exponential is actually. So when we write this, we mean this. Okay, so the module of the complex exponential is the module of this. Okay, so this is the exponential of the sum, and so it's the product of the two exponentials. Okay, so you have this, and this. Okay, the module is the product of the modules. This is minus here. Okay. So you have this, and clearly the module is the absolute value. It's a real number, this. So it's the simple exponential of minus real part of S0t. The module of the second exponential is 1. Remember that the complex exponential e to j a, a real number, is equal to cos a plus j sinus of a. So you see that the module is 1, because it's the cosine square plus sine square.
Excuse me, professor.
Yeah.
In the expansion, the real part and the imaginary part, after imaginary part got separated, why it got negative sign?
Why you got
the negative sign for the imaginary part? E power minus j